Welcome back to the Triple N. The Norfolk Botanical Garden is home to countless plant and wildlife for folk to enjoy. And recently, the Triple N caught up with a group of bird watchers as they got an up-close view of the newest birds in the garden. The baby eaglets also got an up-close view of some biologists.
With lenses in place, their eyes shoot to the sky for that perfect shot of the symbol of America living in Norfolk Botanical Garden.
We're just, you know, photographers that just are, I guess, obsessed with these eagles. We're out here, everybody here is out here about every weekend at least.
Over a dozen self-proclaimed eagle paparazzi frequent the garden on a consistent basis to watch and photograph the two bald eagles that have made Norfolk their home.
It's kind of hard to describe. It's just a beautiful sight and to watch them. And to really, you know, a lot of us here probably think they're like our kids.
They'll need some more cameras soon. Three baby eaglets hatched in this nest in late March at the garden. And in April, they were ready to have their first checkups from the College of William & Mary's Center for Conservation Biology. Too young to fly, they had some help getting to the ground, thanks to Knuckles Tree Service, who raised and roped their way to the nest with bag in hand.
Hi. It's just a real neat experience to be up there, and not many people get to do that, to sit there next to a nest with the American bald eagles.
With mom keeping an eagle eye on the day's events, the newborns were carefully pulled from the nest for their first checkup.
Jeez, you guys are huge.
Everything the biologist told us they would do, they did. They flattened themselves out when we got up there, tried to make them smaller, I guess. And they were real docile when we picked them up and put them in the bag.
Before they were brought down, things got a little interesting.
Gray skies, we're hanging out in a tree with a lightning rod attached to it.
Luckily, the weather held up, and the bag did too.
Good grief, you guys are heavy.
Once the eagles had landed, it was time for the biologist to go to work.
Putting the Fish and Wildlife Service band on the right.
And we put bands on the chicks so they can be identified in the future. We're interested in movement patterns and how long the birds live and where they're moving throughout the Chesapeake Bay.
They were also measured.
37.6.
We get a different sense of how they're growing by measuring different things. Usually the feet sort of get large first. The thing that gives it away is the foot size. So males and females have quite different feet, with males having tiny sort of feet with kind of thin toes.
They were weighed.
It's 2,715 grams.
And feathers were samples for a DNA library.
Yeah, the birds seem to be in great condition, particularly for a three-chick brood. Three chicks is the largest brood that eagles raise, and so to see three chicks in one brood that are doing that well is great.
So great, the biologists decided to show off the eaglets to those who enjoy them the most. The eagle rotsy, which was growing at a faster rate than the eaglets were themselves. They won't have to. Pretty soon, these eaglets will be able to nest and fly anywhere their wings desire, much to the delight of everyone in the garden with a camera.
Of any other animal in the United States, I think to have an American bald eagle nest in the middle of a large city is just absolutely amazing. So they're blessed.
The biologists will return to the garden this month to plant transmitters on the eagles. To learn more about the eagle family in the botanical garden, just log on to www.norfolkeagles.com.